In this video, we will discuss how to export a graph from an already finalized GSYS2 project. This file is a finalized GSYS project. Let me open this file. Here is our finalized project. And we want to export this file. We can export it directly without any customization by clicking the P symbol, which creates a publishable version of the plot. So, I click the symbol and a menu appears here. Since I am not customizing anything, I will click Save and it will ask for the location where I want to save this file. I will give it a name and export it as a PDF by default. We save it. And now the file is saved. Here is the file. Let me open it. And here it is. Now another way is to customize the export. To customize, I click the P symbol again and a detailed menu appears. I will start from the first option, which is text size. The default value is 11, affecting all text in the plot. For example, if I change it to 18, all the text will be updated. I will revert to the default value. Next, we have the symbol for the observed parameter represented by a plus sign. This is the observed type. I have different options to select from, and I can see the changes in the observed pattern. The default size is 8. But I can reduce it to 3 and the size decreases. Then we have the width of the symbol, which is circular. Adjusting the width increases the diameter. I can change the width from a range of options. The next parameter is line width, which affects all lines in the plot, such as the calculated pattern, background, and difference. By default, the line width is 1. If I change it to 3, all lines become thicker. I will revert to 1.5. For text size, the default value is 6. I can increase it to 12 and the text size updates. Similarly, I can change the width from 1 to 2 and it updates accordingly. Next, we have the phases, which are COO and CO3O4. I can change their names in the legend or adjust the spacing between them. There is also an option to show or hide elements. For example, I can hide the observed value by unchecking it, which removes it from the plot. Similarly, I can hide the calculated pattern or background. The zero value is not shown by default, but I can choose to display it. I can also choose whether to show the phases involved. If I hide one phase, it disappears from the plot in legend. Similarly, I can decide what to include in the legend, such as the observe pattern. Unchecking it updates the legends but keeps the plot the same. We have a color selection option to change the colors of the observe pattern and other elements. I can choose a predefined color or customize my own. Next is the pixel per inch setting. Journals usually require at least 300 ppi or dpi, and the default here is 600 ppi per high resolution. We can set the width and height of the figure, such as 8 x 8 inches for a square plot, or the default 8 x 6 inches. The file format is PDF by default, but there are many options like EPS, JPG, PNG, TIFF, and more. For instance, PDF is suitable for LaTeX. We can also export to formats like RAW files, vector graphics, CSV files, and input files for software like Grace, EGOD Pro, and Origin Pro. If I select Origin Pro and try to save, an error appears indicating further installation is needed. GCS2 is Python based, so we need to install Origin Pro through pip. An alternative is to export the data and plot in Origin separately. Let's select the PNG format and save the graph. I will give it a name and save it. The PNG format is lossless and well resolved. The file is now ready. The plot is saved with dimensions of 48,000 by 36,000 pixels due to the 600 ppi setting. For posters and large prints, we need such a high resolution figure. This is how you export an image from GCS2. Thanks for watching the video.